Let me ask you a question and let's get honest for a second, okay? Have you ever launched a Google Ads campaign, you're super pumped, or maybe you've already had one running for a while, and you just go to Google, you know what I mean, just to get a lay of the land. We've all done that, we've all been there, right? We're running our campaigns, we go to Google and we search one of our keywords, and then there's always that one freaking competitor that's always ranked above you. Or even worse, you go to Google, you search one of your keywords, and your ad is nowhere to be seen, and all you see is a list of all these other competition that are popping up when your potential prospect is searching one of your dream keywords, and you don't even know where your ad is. Hey guys, Sylvia Perez from AdConversion, and in today's video, I want to show you how you can flat out outrank your Google Ads competition for good. Now, before I get into this video and the tactics and the how-to, I want to first preface the video by giving you the proper mindset you need to have in order to analyze your campaigns in the first place. For example, in my opinion, your first priority shouldn't be, am I outranking the competition? Your first priority should be, am I getting a positive return on investment on my Google Ads campaigns? And if so, can I reinvest those profits back into my campaigns and scale this out further? But if in the case your goal is to just flat out outrank your competitors, even at the expense of profitability, then I'm going to show you how to do that in this video as well. With that being said, in order for you to flat out outrank your Google Ads competition, you first have to understand where you are in relation to your competition on who's outranking who and how you go about analyzing that data in your account so that you can understand where you stand, where they stand, and then be able to move forward with a plan of attack to optimize what's preventing you from outranking them in the first place. The two critical resources you're really gonna need to know and master in order to understand where you are currently versus the competition so that you can improve your performance and outrank them is first the Auction Insights report and second the competitive metrics available in your Google Ads account. So with that being said, let's first get into the Auction Insights report.
In order to get started with the Auction Insights report, go ahead and hop into your Google Ads account and then go to the Campaigns tab. You can do that by clicking Campaigns on the left-hand side, or you can press G and then C on your keyboard and it'll direct you to the Campaigns tab. Now, once you're here, go ahead and click on Auction Insights right here above Campaign Status, and this is going to direct you to the Auction Insights report. Now, all the Auction Insights report is just a report that gives you a really good understanding on how you're doing in relation to your competitors for your Google Ads keywords. Now, remember, Google Ads is an auction, and in this auction place, you have all these different competitors bidding on these same keywords as you. So this report gives you a really good understanding on how you're doing compared to the rest of the competition. For example, on the left-hand side, you're going to see all the different websites you're competing with. These are all your competitors that are bidding on the same keywords as you in the same locations you are targeting. The next thing you're going to see is impression share. Now, impression share gives you an understanding of all the potential impressions you can get in your account for the keywords you're bidding on and the targeting you have. What percentage of those eligible impressions are you actually receiving in comparison to your competition? So this is a great metric to gauge the visibility you are getting for your keywords compared to your competition. The next thing you can see here is your overlap rate. Your overlap rate tells you what percentage of the time are your ads overlapping in the same search, in the same auction as Google will call it. So if someone goes to Google and they search your keyword, what percentage of the time is your ad and your competition's ads both showing up for the same auction? The next thing is your position above rate. What percentage of the time is your competitor's ads above yours? The next one is top of page rate. This gives you an understanding on what percentage of the time is your ad in one of the top three positions on the Google search page. The next one is your absolute top page rate. The absolute top of page rate tells you what percentage of the time you are in the number one position. So the big discrepancy between top of page rate and absolute top of page rate is top of page rate just means within one of the top three ads, you can be either one, two, or three. And then absolute top of page rate means what percentage of the time you are in the number one spot. And then last but not least, you have outranking share. What percentage of the time is your ad rank higher than your competition or vice versa? So all you need to pay attention to is your impression share, your top of page rate, and your outranking share. Usually those are the three metrics that I focus on the most when it comes to using the Auction Insights report. So let's go ahead and look at the data here. So right now, for me, I have a 29.13% impression share. This competitor here has a 29.14% impression share. So they're slightly getting more visibility than me. I mean, it's almost marginally irrelevant. It's like, what is that, 0.1%? So we're about even on in terms of impression share. They are doing a little bit better than me. So I'm 29.13% and this competitor is 29.14%. So they're getting a little bit more visibility than I am. Now, the next thing I want to look at is the top of page rate. I want to outrank my competition, right? This is what this video is about, is outranking the competitors. So this is going to show you what percentage of the time you are on the top of the page in relation to your competition. So going back to this example, this competitor's top of page rate is 73.95%. My top of page rate for this account is 75.31%. So I am outranking this competitor in the Google Ads auction place. Now, moving forward, if I wanted to see, well, what percentage of the time am I in the number one spot and versus them? I'm 44.57% and they are 42.76%. So that means I'm outranking this competitor when we are in the auction against each other. So when someone searches on that search results page, I'm outranking this competitor the majority of the time. Now, when analyzing your auction insights data, you might run into a situation where you see something like this, and I want to let you know about it so you don't freak out. And that's when you see another competitor with a much higher top of page rate. So if you look at this one competitor, they have a 91.86% top of page rate compared to my 75.31% top of page rate. And you might see that at first and you'll be like, oh my goodness, we are really losing here on the visibility aspect of being on the top of the page. But don't just focus on the top of the page rate. More so, you want to focus on the impression share. The impression share, again, is the total visibility that you're actually receiving for your keywords based on your targeting. This competitor with the 91.86% top of page rate, their impression share is less than 10%. So for the majority of the time, their ad is not even showing because of, you know, whatever it might be. And I'll get into more of how you can improve your account so that way you can actually be on the top of the page the majority of the time and maximize that impression share. But in this case, this competitor, for whatever it might be, they're not, impression share is extremely low. Maybe they're limited by budget, maybe they're limited by ad rank, and they might just have a really, really high bid, but they're getting really restricted by budget, so they're not being, their ad is not being seen the majority of the time. The competitors you really want to focus on the most are the ones that have a higher impression share than you and have a higher top of page rate. Those are the ones that really are red flags. If you see a competitor has a higher impression share and a higher top of page rate, then you are definitely outright losing to them, and you really want to work on improving your account so that you can outrank them. And I'm going to go into the details and the step-by-step on how to outrank your competition and how to improve your account later in this video.
Great. Now that you have a solid understanding of the Auction Insights report, let's get into the competitive metrics you'll need to understand and use in order to understand how you're performing in relation to the competition.
All right, now that you have a really solid understanding of the Auction Insights report, let's get into the competitive metrics you're gonna need to monitor in order to make sure that you are staying ahead of the competition and always gauging how you're doing in relation to them. So to get started, go into your Google Ads account, go into the Campaign tab, and then you're gonna click on Columns, and then you're gonna click Modify Columns, and now we're gonna add these metrics. And you have a lot of different options here in terms of metrics you can monitor in your Google Ads campaigns. I want you to scroll all the way down to competitive metrics, and I want you to enable these checked metrics. So I'm going to go ahead and walk you through each one. So the first one is search impression share. That's what I mentioned in the Auction Insights video. Search impression share is what percentage of the impressions you are eligible to receive for the keywords in your account and the targeting in your account you're actually getting. What percentage of that pie are you actually receiving? The next one is search loss to rank. What percentage of the time are you not, your ads not being displayed because your ad rank is low? And the next one is your search loss to budget. What percentage of the time is your ads not showing because you're just limited by budget? And then the next one is search top impression share. What percentage of the time are you actually in one of those top three positions? This is your top of page rate as is shown in the Auction Insights report. In here, it's called your search top impression share. What percentage of the time you're in those top three spots? And then the last one that I really like is click share. Your click share is very similar to your impression share, and the difference is your click share says of all the potential clicks you can get for your keywords and your targeting, what percentage of that ecosystem, of that targeting that you're reaching for those keywords, what percentage of it, of those clicks that you could get, are you getting in relation to your competition? This one you don't have to have enabled. This is a display campaign, so if you have display campaigns running, you can have the display metrics turned on as well, so you don't have to worry about that one. The only ones I want you to worry about for your search campaigns is search impression share, search loss to rank, search loss to budget, search top IS, or just search top impression share, and then your click share. So once you have those enabled, go ahead and click apply. Now with all your different competitive metric columns enabled, you're gonna be able to see how you're doing in relation to the competition. So for example, now that I have my search impression share metric here, I can see how much visibility I'm actually getting for my campaigns. With the search loss to rank metric here, now I can see what percentage of the time am I not getting that visibility because my ad rank is too low. And then the next one, search loss to budget. What percentage of the time am I not showing my ads just because I just don't have enough money behind these campaigns? And then as well as the search top impression share. What percentage of the time is my ad in one of those top three positions? And then last but not least, what is my click share? Of all the potential clicks I can get for my targeting, what percentage am I actually receiving? So this, with these competitive metrics enabled, now you're gonna be able to gauge your visibility and your performance for these campaigns in relation to the competition. So this is really awesome. So like you can see here for this first campaign, we have a 24.63% search impression share. 66% of the time our ads are not being displayed because we're being lost to rank because our ad rank is low. And then 8.8% of the time our ads are not being displayed because of search loss to budget. As well as 17% of the time we are on the top of the page in one of the top three spots. So for this campaign, I know I got some work to be done because there's a lot of potential for me in terms of visibility for this campaign. If you look at the next campaign right here, I have a 65.33% search impression share. That's pretty good, but that's not 100%, and we want to get it to at least 90 plus, ideally. And it also depends on the campaign type, but you usually want to shoot for 90 plus for your just like standard keywords of people looking for your product or service. Now, 26.38% of the time, my ads are not being seen because of low ad rank, and 8.30% of the time, my ads are not being seen because of loss to budget. So you can see here, this gives you a really good understanding on how you're doing. Now, when my ads are being displayed, 63% of the time they're in one of those top three positions. So with these competitive metric columns, you're gonna be able to really see how each campaign is performing so you can really understand where you are in terms of visibility and more importantly, where you are in terms of the competition.
All right, now that you have a super solid understanding of where you stand in relation to the competition with that Auction Insights report and the competitive metrics you've set up in your account, now let's talk about what's stopping you and how you can address that so you can outrank your competitors. Now, the first way you can outrank your competitors is to raise your budgets. If you go ahead and check in your Google Ads account, if you notice that you are limited by budget, then you're gonna have to raise your budgets if you wanna outrank your competitors. And the reason being is Google can't serve your ads if they ran out of money. So if in the case you are limited by budget, you're gonna have to go ahead and put more money into your campaigns so that you can get more visibility and be able to outrank those competitors. The second way you can outrank your competition is improving your quality score. If in the case when reviewing your competitive metrics, you notice that the number one thing hurting your search impression share is loss to rank, that means you have a low ad rank. And the way you're gonna improve your ad rank is by increasing your quality score or increasing your max cost per click bids. Now, if you wanna learn more about how to improve your ad rank, I actually made a whole video on this. You can check that out. The link will be in the description box down below. But a quick summary of how to improve your ad rank is you're gonna wanna keep testing ads so you can improve your expected click-through rate. You're gonna wanna make sure that you grouped your ad groups to your keywords correctly and that it's relevant and then you have an above average ad relevance. And you wanna make sure you're sending people to relevant landing pages that are congruent with your ads and keywords. All this is gonna play into a factor in calculating your quality score, and your quality score is going to impact your ad rank. So if you have a very high search loss to rank, that means you have a low ad rank, and your competitors have better quality scores than you, and they're just flat out outranking you. So in that case, you want to go ahead and make sure you are focusing in on improving your quality score, because that's not only going to help you from a cost perspective and reduce your cost, but that's also going to help you get your ad seen more often and improve your search impression share so you can outrank them and get more visibility in the auction place. Last but not least, the third and final way for you to outrank your Google Ads competition is to test different bid strategies. Google offers a lot of different bid strategies out there. You want to go ahead and test and play with different bid strategies, run some campaign experiments, test 50% of your original campaign versus 50% of the experiment campaign with the new bid strategy that you're testing. If you're not sure how to use campaign experiments, I actually made a video on that. I'll link it in the description box down below, but make sure you're testing these different bid strategies and see which one works best for your account, which one negatively impacts your competitive metrics, and which one positively impacts your competitive metrics. And not only that, as well as your ROI, which one is generating more conversions for you, and vice versa. Now, if in the case you are more focused on just outranking the competition flat out at the cost of ROI, I have one last tip for you in how you can do that. And that's using the target impression share bid strategy. The target impression share bid strategy is extremely competitor focused, where you are going after maximum visibility. And I'm gonna show you how to use that right now.
Now, if you wanna use a target impression share bid strategy, this strategy is if you just wanna flat out outrank the competition, you are looking for maximum visibility at the expense of ROI. So you're not necessarily focused with ROI with this bid strategy, you want visibility. Because with this strategy, what you're gonna do is you're gonna allow Google to set your bid limits for you. They're gonna set your keyword bids in order for you to get the maximum impression share, the maximum visibility possible for your campaign and your targeting. So if this is something you're interested in, go ahead and click on the campaign that you want to set this for, and then go down to settings, and then from here, you're going to go ahead and go down to bidding, and then you click change strategy, and then click select directly, and then from here on the dropdown, click target impression share. And now it's going to ask you, where do you want your ads to appear? We're going to switch this to top of results page, anywhere in the top three spots. What percent of impression share are you looking to target? We want 100% because we want max exposure. And then from there, set your max cost per click bid limit. So after doing keyword research, let's say we decided our max bid limit is going to be $10. And then just click save. Now with this strategy, Google is going to work within your bid limit. So anything up into $10 in this case, and they're going to optimize your bids to get you that maximum exposure within that bid limit that you set. Again, this strategy is ideal if you're looking for that visibility. I do not recommend this strategy if you're focused on ROI, because with this strategy, Google is going to optimize for visibility versus conversion. If you're interested more in ROI, I recommend automated bid strategies with conversion like target CPA or max conversions, or I recommend just manual CPC bidding and you set your individual keyword level bids to get that maximum ROI. But if in the case you are looking to just flat out get as much visibility as possible at the expense of cost, this strategy might be for you.
That is it for this video. I hope you got tremendous value from it. If you did, if you can like the video, that'll help me out a ton to get it ranked higher in the search engines. And if you like content like this on Google advertising, feel free to subscribe to the channel and click that bell notification icon so you can be notified of future content I post on a weekly basis. And if in the case that you want to learn more about Google advertising, I highly recommend you check out my 7-step checklist for launching successful Google advertising campaigns. It's coming out soon. It's a new book I'm coming out with, and you can find the details to that in the description box down below. And if there are any topics that I haven't covered on this channel on Google advertising that you'd like me to, feel free to drop me a message or a comment down below, and I'll be more than happy to learn how I can better serve you so that you can have profitable Google advertising campaigns. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Take care.